अस्सलामु अलैकुम, वेलकम टू सेवेंथ क्लास सोशल। आई एम योर सोशल टीचर फ्रॉम यूनाइटेड पब्लिक स्कूल तांडूर।
सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट लेसन वी स्टार्ट? यस, वी वाज स्टार्ट रेन एंड रिवर्स। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव डन सम टॉपिक्स, सो लेट अस अबाउट टुडेज टॉपिक। ओके, देर आर सेवरल वाटर बॉडीज ऑन द अर्थ सरफेस। Yes, students, what do you mean by water bodies? Yes, oceans, rivers, lakes, etc. are the water bodies. Okay, there is constant evaporation of water from these water bodies. In fact, whenever there is moisture, evaporation will take place. There is evaporation from our bodies, from trees, plants and soils. The process of evaporation speed up with the increase in temperature. Yes, so here you can see on your screen, this is evaporation. There are several water bodies on the earth now. So from ponds, from rivers, from oceans, like etc. And the process of evaporation speeds up with the increase in temperature. Let us know how the clouds are formed. Okay, formation of clouds and rains. When there is rise in temperature, water vapor rises and reaches high up in the sky. So students, what happen when the temperature is very high? The water vapors reach up in the sky, okay, and it gets cool. This is because the atmosphere gets cooler as we rise above the surface of the earth. Yes, after the evaporation, the water vapors get cool. Okay, with the cooling, water vapors is transformed into tiny water droplets. So after this, what happened? Yes, these change into water, tiny means small water drops. Okay, these droplets gather around minute dust or smoke particles in the air and gradually increase in size. These small drops of water gather to form the clouds. What happened? Yes, after the evaporation, the air gets cool, and after this they become a small water drops, and after this they change into the clouds. Okay, this is the process formation of clouds and rain. Okay, let us know about some important terms. In our previous class, I already discussed with you evaporation. What is evaporation? Change of water into vapors is known as evaporation. Yes, in which process the water change into vapors is called evaporation. The process in which water vapors change into water is called condensation. Yes, when the water vapors is changing into water is called condensation. Okay, clouds are tiny droplets of water hanging in the air above. So my dear students, what do you mean by evaporation? Yes, changes of water into water vapors is called evaporation. And next, in the another side, what is the meaning of condensation? Yes, the process which the water vapors change into water, the opposite of evaporation, is called condensation. Okay, next, water cycle. The process of water evaporating from the seas, forming clouds in the sky, coming down as air, flowing down the slopes on land in the form of rivers, and finally joining the sea, is called the water cycle. Yes, students, what do you mean by water cycle? Yes, this is a process. Okay, this is a process of evaporating water from the seas. Okay, and the clouds are formed in the sky. But after the rain was come, what happened? Yes, the water will be flowed onto the slopes on the land in the form of river, and they finally join the sea. Okay, the water will be come indirectly join the sea is called the water cycle. Okay, students, today's your homework is you have to write what is evaporation and what is water cycle. You have to write the definition of these two processes. Okay, hope you all are understand. Thank you. Write neatly and submit in the group.